altar tour. Here you go. So we're gonna start up here. That's my witch's, whoa. That's my witch's ball. I clean it often because it collects so much negativity. So that's sweet basil and regular basil. And then there's my grandma. Then on my altar, I have Samael and Lilith. And then on the left is the, oh god, witch father. On the right is the witch mother. I have Thoth and I have Isis, which I really don't do the, you know, those mysteries anymore, the Egyptian mysteries. So those are gonna go, but I do really, really, really love this one right here, the horseshoe candle holder. Very powerful, especially in traditional witchcraft. Have Hecate or Hecate, whatever you want to call her, the mother of all. Some basic just salt. It's not holy salt, so don't be fooled by the label. Then I have more Hecate. So yeah, she needs new coffee. Lots of petitions or key. Little bells to call her. My drinking horn. This is for my ancestors right here. There's my Gani. Her candle, lots of feathers. Stuff that she got me from Hawaii. So we got a lot of stuff going on there. My grandpa's little funeral thingy. Oh, that's my chalice. So there's my chalice. What else? Down here we have, let's see, that's the fairy realm, the fairy door. There's my, one of my servitors. It's Elfheim. My house gnome, pretty much. And then that's just little crystals and stuff that they like. A little lamp that I've had since I was 14, 16. Just oils. Oils. A vessel for Azazel. Machete. My cauldron. We have the wand. So the wand was given to me by Blue Witch. I love it. That's my other wand. I don't know why there's a holy Bible there. I hate it. There's that claw thing that keeps growing that I take pictures of for you guys. Pretty much that, but this is my pine wood wand. And then that's that morning star looking type thing, and that's made of pine too. So over here I've got Baphomet, everything that he likes, so this is good. Everything that he likes. I have a singing bowl, I have a drum, lots of necklaces, pendants, jewelry, talismans, amulets. My salt rock lamp. And then there's my, pretty much my necromancy altar. So I have the skull, which has been consecrated in a specific way. My Orgon pyramid that is supposed to help and, you know, facilitate communication between the worlds. And my crystal ball. There's a spirit house that I made quite a long time ago. There's a book, Eli Popa, one of my relatives from Romania. Give Us a Stay. He wrote that, translated it from Romanian literature to English. There is a Ouija that is made by Jesse. Here's my very first Ouija. Love it. Little protection pouches and stuff that I've gotten from some very amazing people. Lots of feathers. The biggest, blackest one right there is, yeah, a crow or a raven feather, so I would say that would be Malthus. Yeah, just all kinds of stuff. I have the claws, chicken claws, that will basically protect me. And then I have, I don't know, that's just a really pretty thing right here, with a little angel on it that I got from my Lou from London. So, I mean, basically there's so much stuff on here. There's witch bottles, there's, you know, different kinds of waters. There's so much going on here. Crystals, it's a mess. So yeah, this is my basic setup right here in my stang, which I'm not too happy with, but it works for now. So it's pretty interesting. I like that. So yeah, this is my altar tour, which you guys see all the time. I have selenite down there. It should be up on top because selenite is basically to bring in better energies. And again, Ouija heaven everywhere. My credentials of ministry, Ouija queen, Swami board, little witch balls, just everything. A mask, that was when we were doing mask magic as a group. So yeah, it's just a really, really nice. I love my setup. It's been here for about 19 years, so it's got a lot of energy around it, and I love it. So yeah. Alright guys, well, I hope you guys enjoy, and thank you guys for watching, and we will pan in on her to say goodbye. So I love you guys. Stay safe, be healthy, and I will see you all tomorrow.